decades back, when I was graduated in 93. And if you compare today, we see that there is a paradigm shift. Not only the way we are teaching as a teacher, but the entire scenario is shifting from one direction to other. Now today, if we go to, as a teacher, if we go to the classrooms, the biggest challenge is not to teach what is written in the books, because the students are well informed. The contents, at once upon a time, when we used to study, we used to depend on mostly on the teacher who is coming to the class for the contents. I still remember when in 90, when I took admission in computer applications, I had to purchase a book on computer networks. I belong to Varanasi. BHU is one of the largest universities of Asia. And it was told that if you go around BHU, you will find everything, whatever is required. And for that, book on computer network by Tannenbaum, and a book by book of data structure by Tremblay Sorensen. I had to travel from Varanasi. I could not get. I came to Lucknow. I could not get. And then I had to come to Delhi. And in Naisarak, at some shop, I could get. And how many students could have done that, to travel from Varanasi to Delhi to get a book? So mostly those students were dependent on teachers, even for contents. Now today, if you go to the classroom, if you take a topic, and if you start teaching in the class, before you speak the definition, the student is ready with a question. Now, the biggest challenge is, as a teacher, am I ready to respond to those things? Number one. Second, now, because of this availability of knowledge, because of this proliferation of technology, especially information technology, the availability of resources, availability of best of the professors on through video conferencing or through internet, where you can get the connected contents from them. Now, as a teacher, my role at my institute is changing. Now we are not merely a teacher, but now our role is becoming a facilitator who facilitates the learning process. Means the shift, the paradigm shift, is from teacher-centric level. Is shifting towards the learner centric. Now it is the student who decides what contains has to be given. Now it is the student who writes the class how that class has to run. And in that process, as a teacher, am I ready for that? For example, just for, I will take 2 minutes. After 6-7 years, the university has revised its curriculum. A new subject on big data was introduced. Nobody bothers who is going to teach that subject big data to the student. Because the faculty who is going to teach that subject big data, from where the faculty will come. Now the faculty who is in existence, he is given that subject. And irony is, without adding the practical component of big data, or advanced databases, or cloud computing, or mobile application development, this is one of the very renowned university, it has introduced mobile application development as a subject, it is a practical component. Now if we are teaching, if it means if our system is working like that, means we are having the aspirations of 21st century or 22nd century, tools of 20th century, but the thought process remains of 19th century. There's a huge gap that needs to be understood, that needs to be bridged. And as a teacher, as a member of academic fraternity, we all need to sit on this, discuss, and find out the ways as how we chart out the point 1, 2, 3, 4. That our discussion leads to those few points which can be practically implemented, and those implementations ensure that these gaps are filled.
Thank you very much. And I think we will have to take up many questions.